Good afternoon, and I want to thank all of you for coming out to help us celebrate Memorial Day 2016. This year marks 150 years since Union veterans first remembered those of their number who died in the Civil War. Memorial Day was officially declared by federal law in 1967 to honor those who gave their lives in all wars. In every society, there are many callings. The path of the warrior is one of the most difficult paths of service. Throughout history, warriors have been called upon to protect their families, their communities, and their country, to fight for others' safety and freedom, knowing that this path of service may include their life and the suffering of their loved ones. The path of the warrior requires the qualities of courage, commitment, and resilience. Courage to face the horror and brutality of war. Commitment to leave your loved ones behind to make sure they remain safe. And the resilience to keep your humanity in the face of inhumanity. Politics and public opinion ebb and flow like the ocean's tide, but the path of the warrior is steadfast. He understands duty and honor. No one desires peace more than the warrior and their families, for they know the true cost of war. They know that freedom has never been free, and that the price of freedom has always been the blood of the warrior. These warriors have never sought war, but they've never flinched when their country called on them to serve. Memorial Day is a day when we pay our respects to those who gave their last full measure of devotion to the nation. It is through their actions and sacrifices that we enjoy the blessings of liberty. It is through the tears of their families that we have the freedoms that we often take for granted. Today and every day, let us be thankful that they were willing to lay down their lives for one of God's greatest gifts, liberty. We should not forget the pain of the families who also suffered by the loss of a son or a daughter in the service of our country. Gold Star Mothers is an organization of mothers who have lost children in wartime service. If there are any Gold Star mothers or members of Gold Star families in the audience today, would you please stand and be recognized? We honor you today as well as we and offer our deepest sympathy for your loss and sacrifice. Thank you so much. 2015 through 2017 has been designated as the commemoration of the 50th anniversary of the Vietnam War. The Fort Smith National Cemetery is a commemorative partner to recognize all Vietnam War veterans who served in that war and their families. We will plan two more special events this year to honor Vietnam veterans and their families. We will announce those events at a later date. Let us now honor our flag. It is the symbol of our great nation, and it represents the American spirit and our love of liberty. We veterans hold our flag dear and will continue to proudly defend it even today. Would you please stand as we honor our flag and remain standing for the singing of the national anthem and our invocation. Color guard, post the colors.
Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this great nation that you have blessed. We believe that this country was founded on you and your love letter to us. We remember those in harm's way today and pray for your protection over them. Bless their families as well. And for all of those who've paid the ultimate sacrifice, oh, we are so grateful, and we will never forget the debt that was paid so we could be here today. We bless you and thank you. In Christ's name I pray. Amen.
I'd like to call Mayor Sandy Sanders to the podium to introduce our honored guests.
Well, thank you, and it is a pleasure once again to welcome you to this very special remembrance of our veterans on this Memorial Day. I will introduce the new director of the National Cemetery in just a moment, but I want to thank him ahead of time, him and his crew, for how beautiful our National Cemetery is, the care that it receives, and also thanks to the students in the Portsmouth School System for placing flags at each and every headstone. Portsmouth is a community of volunteers, and this service is organized as it is each year, as well as Veterans Day, by the Avenue of Flags Committee. That's a very anonymous group. There are people who have served you and served our country. They don't often get recognized, so at this time, if there are any members of the Avenue of Flags Committee here and willing to do so, would you please make yourself known, stand, raise your hand. Some are here, I know. People don't realize the amount of time and physical effort it takes to do the flag placement each year, and then when this service is over, when this program is over next week, what happens? Nobody else will be here, but these folks will be here to take down and preserve our flag. At this time, we do have a number of special guests with us, and as I introduce them, would you please hold your applause until they have all been introduced. State Representative District 80, Charlene Feit, B.G. Hendricks, Ann Betts, Mayor of Greenwood, Doug Kinslow, Sharon Brooks, Sebastian County Clerk, Terry Gothard, State President, VFW Auxiliary, Justin Boyd, State Representative, District 77, Carter Ferguson, Commander, DAV Chapter 1, Emery Dockery, Darby Foundation President, Carl Gifkin, Portsmouth City Administrator, Stanley Kilgore, Chapter 467, Vietnam Veterans of America President, Vin Tron, Senior Citizen President, Vietnamese, and Cop Pham, Vice President of the Senior Vietnamese Senior Citizens. Bobby Pike, American Legion Commander. David Hudson, Sebastian County Judge. Richard McKinney, VFW Post 6527 Commander. Michael Skidmore, Veterans of Foreign Wars Post 8845 in Fort Smith Commander. Gary Lawrence, Mayor, City of Huntington, and you'll hear more from Gary shortly. Keith Sparks Gray, Commander, Combat Vets Motorcycle Association. Doug Blair, Marine Corps League and Auxiliary Commandant. Kelsey Kelton, Senator John Bozeman's Field Representative. Danny Aldridge, Sebastian County Corps of Court, Justice of the Peace, District 6. Billy Dooley, Board Chairman, Military Officers Association of America, and this gentleman who's become a very close friend, I saved him for last, J.W. Taylor, American XPOW Association past commander, World War II Battle of the Bulge veteran. At this time, it's my honor to introduce Howard Porter, the Director of Portsmouth National Cemetery. Again, Howard, your crew has just done a marvelous job, as they always do. And we're fortunate here with the Avenue Flags Committee and other veterans organizations to have such a positive working relationship with our National Cemetery. We've heard and we know it's the envy of all National Cemeteries across the country. Howard?
I see folks in the cemetery on a daily basis paying respect to their loved ones' graves, but today we gather in unity to pay tribute to and honor all 14,283 veterans interred in this national shrine. These veterans represent all branches of the military service through 17 war periods. To ensure this sacrifice is not forgotten, the National Cemetery Administration has developed the Veterans Legacy Program, which offers interactive maps, lesson plans, and videos focusing on honoring the sacrifices of our nation's veterans. These tools are being developed for each of the 134 national cemeteries and are not only designed to assist educators, but the general public as well. These can be found on the NCA website as they become completed and uploaded. I want to thank the Avenue of Flags Committee for putting this event together in such a dignified manner. I also want to thank the cemetery employees for their devotion and dedication in maintaining this peaceful setting. And I thank you for joining us today.
At this time, it's my pleasure to introduce Gary Lawrence, who's the mayor of Huntington and former fire chief, and he's got a magnificent voice, and it's my fault that I put Williamson on the program. So, Gary, I ask your forgiveness.
Not a problem. I do want to thank all the veterans that fought and kept our country free. And this song is dedicated to them. If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my God above to be living here today, 'cause that flag still stands for freedom, and you can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, from New York to LA, where there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say that I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. again, Gary. Your magnificent voice really brings that song to life for us. And I think I've told you all before, and I'm going to digress just a moment. Many years ago, Lee Greenwood was here in Fort Smith to do a show at the Arkansas-Oklahoma State Fair. And during that concert, he came out and he said, "You know, I've been working on a new song, and I want to try it out on you for the first time." So that song was first heard with no band backing him up. He just sat up, stood on the stage at Harper Stadium here and presented for the first time "God Bless the USA" here in Fort Smith, Arkansas. Well, it is an honor to introduce our speaker today, and I encourage you to read the program for more information about him. Tom Quang Pham was born in the South of Vietnam to Christian missionaries. During the Vietnam War, he spent 9 years in the South Vietnamese Air Force serving as head of a translator. The story of his miracle escape from South Vietnam as communist forces rolled across his country is a testament to a Christian's steadfast faith in God and his quest for freedom at all costs. Upon arriving in the United States, with almost nothing except some personal clothing and family possessions, he began to build a new life in a foreign land. He has earned 2 bachelor's degrees from the University of Saigon and an MBA and a BA from U.S. universities, and currently is a doctoral student. For 11 years, he was a finance and marketing specialist for Rockwell International Avionics Division and spent 17 years as senior editor-translator of the Vietnamese Bible Project. He is an author, student, and teacher, currently teaching at Kimmins Junior High School and at the Fort Smith Adult Education Center. His wife, Twan, is a floral designer for Hobby Lobby, and they have 2 married daughters, both of whom have graduate degrees from U.S. University. Please welcome Tom Fine.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm proud and humbled to stand in front of you today to share my feelings about the value of freedom. Having run away from a country where freedom only exists on paper, I appreciate the real freedom that America offers, but freedom always involves heavy costs in human lives. Today, we the living, stand solemnly in front of the resting place of our fellow citizens whose lives have been sacrificed for an ideal that all of us cherish, freedom and liberty. It was no coincidence that the Founding Fathers had inserted this famous statement in the preamble of the Constitution. We are all endowed with certain inalienable rights to life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness. Those rights are what make America not only great, but a model for countries whose citizens never have tasted them. And in the pursuit of happiness and liberty, often lives have to be given up, as our fallen heroes whose resting places surround us today show. We normally take freedom and liberty for granted until it is threatened or taken away from us. Freedom and liberty is so valued by every human being that all countries in the world reserve the right to take away the freedom of anyone who breaks the law or is a threat to society by locking them up behind bars. Life without freedom is meaningless. Freedom without the ability to pursue happiness is hollow. The Chinese have the saying, "One day in jail is equal to 1,000 years in freedom." Jesus Christ said, "Greater love has no one than this, that a person lays down his life for his friends." Jesus has done this for all of us by dying on the cross. Today we gather around this place to remember those who have laid down their lives for us, so we and our children can live in freedom. This past century witnessed 2 great wars and some major conflicts, with millions of lives lost, world peace threatened. The reason for such tragedies: some countries want to impose a yoke of slavery on others. America saved the world in World War II and fought courageously to contain communism, whose forces tried to impose their atheistic ideology in South Korea. And I believe the Korean people will forever be grateful to America to save the country from carrying the yoke of dictatorship. 41 years ago, America ended a conflict in Vietnam, a small country halfway around the world. The message was clear. Americans would not hesitate to fight for freedom if it is threatened, regardless where it came from. As I stand before you today, I can never find enough words to express my gratitude to thousands of Americans' lives lost in Vietnam, fighting for freedom. For a noble goal that all Vietnamese long to have, the right to live in peace. When it comes to freedom, the world finds two kinds of people, those who seek freedom and those who fight for freedom. Both risk their lives to obtain the most cherished asset, the right to live in freedom. 500,000 Vietnamese lost their lives in the open sea while trying to reach the shore of liberty on flimsy boats. 58,000 American soldiers died fighting for freedom. We today celebrate Memorial Day, praising those who have laid down their lives while fighting for liberty. America is an example of real freedom where opportunities to advance are open to everybody. Have you ever wondered why America attracts millions of immigrants throughout the world every year? Because America offers freedom and opportunities not found nor available in their homeland. America is not perfect, yet it offers opportunities for those who are willing to make it better. Stories of poor immigrants rising in this society as a result of hard work abound. 40 years ago, such names as Nguyen, Tran, Pham, etc. were unheard of in America. Now, they are commonly mentioned whenever success stories are discussed, be it in business or in education. Leaving one's homeland is not easy because one has to deal with differences in culture, language, religions, etc. Despite those obstacles, freedom to advance is a guarantee to a better life. We human beings all value life and fear death. But to those who are lying here in front of us today, they were willing to give up their lives so that their loved ones, including all of us standing here, can enjoy the kind of asset that only freedom can give. Let us forget that the great love and sacrifice for us. Let us not hesitate to follow the examples whenever freedom needs to be defended. Let us celebrate Memorial Day with a humble attitude and a grateful thought, recognizing that when necessary, no sacrifice is too big if it involves freedom and liberty. And finally, we should not appreciate freedom and sacrifice only once a year, but let us make a goal to value them on a daily basis. In so doing, we can be proud citizens of this great country where freedom and liberty reigns.
Thank you so much, and we're proud to have you in our country, and we're proud to have the other Vietnamese who live in our community. We're glad to have you too. Thank you so much for being our comrades in a vicious war against communism. At this time, I'd ask my buddies from the River Blenders to come up. We're going to sing another song. And we're going to get some audience participation too, and I will let Ron Bergenstock, our director, explain how we're going to make that work.
Very simple process. We're going to sing a part song. We're going to sing a song first, then we're going to have you sing, and then what we're going to do is you're going to sing that song, and we're going to put it together. Trust me, it works.
Oh, man, yeah.
Let freedom ring, awakening the pride in every American, standing tall with one and all. Good and building. gracious sky for amber waves of grain, for purple mountain majesty among the fruited plain. America, America, God shed his grace on thee.
Now we come to a part of the program where I kind of correlate to flying by the seat of your britches. We're going to lay some wreaths, laying wreaths, the memorial wreaths today and tomorrow all across the land. People will be laying wreaths to memorialize those we honor here today. We don't always get feedback from organizations that are going to lay wreaths, so that's why I say we started flying by the seat of our britches. And as I call your organization's name, would you please present your wreath? And if I don't call your name, would you come by right here, tell me who you are so I can announce you, and then go across with the, where the other wreaths are. AmVets Post number 2. American Legion, Post 31. And American Legion, Post 31 Auxiliary. Arkansas Retired Military Association and Auxiliary. Darby Foundation. Disabled American Vets, Post 1 and Auxiliary, and Junior Auxiliary. Darby Chapter, Military Officers Association of America. Daughters of the American Revolution, Fort Smith Chapter. Fraternal Order of Eagles, Auxiliary. Military Order of the Purple Heart, Chapter 587. Next Step Homeless Services. River Valley Detachment, 1248. Marine Corps League and Auxiliary. River Valley Veterans National Cemetery Association, VFW District 7, VFW Post 1322, and Auxiliary from Van Buren, VFW Post 8845 here in Fort Smith, and Auxiliary, Vietnam Veterans of America, Chapter 467 and Auxiliary, POWMIA, Sons of Confederate Veterans, General Richard M. Gano, Camp 561, VFW Post 6527 from Greenwood, and Combat Veterans Motorcycle Association, AR Arkansas 7-3 from Mountain Burg.
Thank you. an occasion like this.
I would like to thank everyone who participated in today's ceremony. It was listed on the program, even if I got your name wrong. We couldn't have done this ceremony without you. Chase Carter was not able to lead the River Valley Community Band today, so Angie Clark stepped up and did a fine job. I want to thank you to the band for playing for us. The outstanding buglers from Southside High School were Aaron Stewart and Wesley Schwartz. I appreciate Sean Carrier for providing these young musicians for us every ceremony. I thank Mayor Sanders for providing our shuttle service and the secretary for doing our program. And we owe a great debt of gratitude to Gary Hammer, who's on the board of the Salvation Army, for providing water. If you need to get a bottle of water before you leave to help allay the sweat that you have dispensed during the ceremony, please do so. Thanks to the Darby Junior High ninth grade class for putting out the flags on Tuesday. They're a fine group of youngsters and a very patriotic young people, and I appreciate Waldo Fisher for starting that tradition and giving those youngsters a taste of patriotism. Again, I would be remiss if I didn't thank Director Howard Porter and his superb staff for maintaining this cemetery in the immaculate condition that you see it just about every time you come out here. And for many of us, this will be our final resting place. If I left anybody out, please forgive me. And I will be available for rear end chewings at the end of the ceremony out back. The Avenue Flag Committee appreciates the support of everyone that helps make these ceremonies successful, and I want to thank you all again for being here today. Reverend Hutchins will come forward to lead us in our benediction now.
And he's giving out all the thank yous, but thank you, Ed. Let's give him a hand. Let's pray the Lord's Prayer together, and then I'll conclude with a word of prayer. Join me, please. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Father, we thank you for this great occasion. Thank you for the patriotism we sense here and the love of country. Thank you most of all for sending your son to take our place. Wow, what a day this is. We will always remember. I pray this in Christ's holy name. Amen.
Amen. Donuts. Forward.
Thank you. You may be seated.
Dale. Oh.
On this Memorial Day, I would like General Norman H. Schwarzkopf, commander of U.S. troops during the First Gulf War, made a statement that pretty well sums up what this day is all about. He said, and I quote, "A professional soldier understands that war means killing people. War means maiming people. War means families left without fathers and mothers. All you have to do is hold your first dying soldier in your arms and have that terribly futile feeling that his life is flowing out and you can't do anything about it. That's when you really understand the horror of war. Any soldier worth his salt should be anti-war. And yet, there are still things worth fighting for. Thank you again for attending our ceremony this afternoon. We are blessed that there are still young men and women today that volunteer to serve our nation, to go in harm's way, and to endure hardships and deprivations to protect our nation and preserve our freedom and the freedom of others. God bless them all and bring them home safely. Please remember them in your prayers. Also, I would ask you to be prayerful for our nation. As you look around at the things that are occurring across the land today, you can't help but realize that we are in dire trouble. God will only bless us so far. And when we turn our backs on God, we're on our own. So be safe on your way home. And I hereby declare these proceedings dismissed. Thank you very much.
Hey.
I'm sweating.
I know, I tried. I worked that in a half hour, and that's all I could do.
Hey.
Right, man.
Oh, but I am just good. Melting.
Yeah, me too. Yeah.
We were ready for this ceremony. We got it all. Got it all.
Cool.
Bugles, gunners, everybody.
Good.
This is right there.